Welcome back, everyone. This video will discuss methods you can use to solve single variable polynomials, particularly the quadratic type. Single variable polynomials are equations of the following form: a times x to the power of n plus b times x to the power of n minus 1, and so on, plus j equals to 0. N can be any whole number, while a, b, and j are called constants in math, which means they are just numbers. X is the variable in the equation that we want to solve for. An example of a third degree polynomial is the equation written at the bottom, 3x cubed plus 2x squared plus 1 equals 0. As you know, when n is equal to 2, we have a quadratic equation of the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. In Chem 12, you will see quadratic equation or higher polynomials appearing when you are in the process of solving problems related to the concept of chemical equilibrium. For a quadratic equation, we can solve for x using the quadratic formula. The quadratic formula is shown on the slide. Keep in mind that to use the quadratic formula, the quadratic equation must be written in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Make sure you memorize this formula, as it will be useful later when we discuss chemical equilibrium. Here's an example of how to use the quadratic formula. Since the equation is not yet written in the correct form, we must rearrange it so it is appropriate for the quadratic formula. That means it must be written in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. In this quadratic equation, your a is 1, your b is minus 4, and your c is minus 8. Plugging those values into the quadratic formula gives two possible x values, x1 equals 5.5 and x2 equals negative 1.5. Typically, if you are solving a quadratic equation in chemistry, it is to determine molar concentration. So a negative value in your answer doesn't make sense and can be rejected. A second method to solving polynomials is called successive approximation. This is a trial and error method, where first we guess for the value of x, called input x. We then substitute this input value into all terms containing x, except for 1. We then solve for the unsubstituted x. This value is called the output x. If the input and output values match, we have a solution, and this is called convergence. If the values don't match, we must repeat the steps until they do. Here's an example of a quadratic equation you may see in a chemical equilibrium problem. We first try an input x value of 2 times 10 to the minus 5. We substitute this value into x, but leave the x squared term unsubstituted. We then solve for the x in the x squared term, giving us an output value of 3.7 times 10 to the power of minus 5. Since the input and output values are different, we have not solved the equation, so we must repeat the steps. For cycle 2, we use the output of the first cycle as the input. So the input x is 3.7 times 10 to the power of minus 5. This results in an output x value of 3.3 times 10 to the power of minus 5. We repeat the cycle a couple more times, and we see that in cycle 4, we have the same values of input and output x, which means we have reached convergence and found the correct solution to the equation. Although successive approximation can be used for any ordered polynomial, we will use it only for third degree polynomials or higher, since the quadratic formula can be used for the second degree polynomial.